you who were at the first meeting, there was a doctor by the name of Lloyd Rudy, who was absolutely an amazing clinician and who made a very big impact on our academy and passed away a few years ago. In his honor, because he made such an impact on our lives and to the friends around us, we have created an award in his name for leadership in this academy. And it is my honor to announce the next winner of this award, the Lloyd Rudy Award, and it goes to Dr. Dan Sindelar. If he could come up. Big things that is going to in turn come back to our academy and our mission in big ways. And I want him to share with you what he's up to, what he's been doing since he's moved beyond the board. And I'm telling you, I am so proud and so honored to call this man my friend. Yeah.
Thank you. You know, family is wonderful, I mean, the most important part of it, all of our lives, but besides that, my professional career has all been just heightened with AAOSH and the people I've met, and seeing the people that were there at the beginning was just extraordinary, and we've got so many here, and seeing all of the new faces, gosh, I just can't tell you. So I'd love to give you a little idea of who Lloyd was, just because I'm so humble. Lloyd Rudy, was considered number two cardiologist of all time. And Lloyd did the Rudy and DeWu piece in New England Journal of Medicine back in the late 70s, showing that a heart attack was because of an inflammatory fibrin clot, also stroke. So all of the anticoagulants that are used today, when we take our anticoagulating aspirin every morning, and when someone's at risk for a stroke, all of that is based on Lloyd's wonderful, wonderful work. And I met him early, and this glorious man made this, wasn't young man, but this dentist feel like he could play a key role. And he gave me confidence, and it was so glorious, and I cannot tell you how happy I am to receive this award with his name on it. It was not my intent to suggest that, thinking I would ever stand in his footprints. But Lloyd was a beautiful mentor for me, the most kind, considerate human being I've ever met. Look for your mentors. Look for the people that mentor you, and then mentor others. And it'll be the most rewarding thing in the world. So to put it into perspective, when we started, we were everybody in this room, and everybody that's been with us has been so involved with pushing the subject, oral systemic health. What the heck is that? And it is now to a point where it is so extraordinarily into our everyday lives. So to put it into perspective, and Stephanie asked me to do this. I love being on the board. The last year, I have not been on the board to do some of the other things. I just needed the time. But I formed a company called Oral Genomics, and in partnership, it's company called ADVAX, and ADVAX is developing microbiome-sparing solutions for Alzheimer's and cardiovascular disease, all based on the science. Nothing but science, 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 science. We're all in the page, and I see Bill, and Bill, God bless you, your assistance with the science is remarkable. I can stand on this stage right now and tell you, because I'm privy to research that's going to be coming out in the next 3 months, that Alzheimer's is a pathogen-directed disease. It is completely a pathogen-directed disease. There are lifestyle triggers that play key roles. All of the things that we put in place over the last 5 years are perfect for this. And the wellness side of it is going to be how we reduce the impact. The long-term adjustment of the specific strains of pathogen are gonna be how we cure it. And believe it or not, we all are gonna be in on it. I will keep you posted on things that I can bring out as they become possible. And they're gonna do a documentary on PBS next year, and it's just on neurodegenerative, and that's gonna be coming out late next year. So sharpen your tools, pay attention to all of the things that's taught here. Look into wellness extraordinarily, because that will play a key role. Sleep, unwanted stress, some nutritional points, all the things that we all pay attention to. And it's an unbelievable future. So I didn't mean to go that long. Stephanie, you're absolutely glorious.
You are perfect. We all want to hear this. Is this not exciting information? Is this great to do?
Keep yourself open to the universe. Things will come your way. I'm very philosophical about this. We have an NIH grant we've applied for, and there's members of the academy that are assisting, and there's also the majority of my team are people that have spoken in previous conferences, and this will be so much fun for all of us. But the NIH grant, we're going to hear about it, whether it's accepted or not. They moved it up early. We're going to get our confirmation or not confirmation in 2 weeks. If we don't get it, I know we'll get it in January. It's going to be an over $5 million NIH grant, largest cohort study, looking at Alzheimer's disease, microbial burden, inflammatory markers, and genetic makeup. And it is just custom made for everything we do in this room. So in honor of Lloyd Rudy, I'm so humbled I can't tell you. I would love, this is the kind of relationship, this would be my last story. This is a Lloyd Rudy story. Lloyd and I, at the first meeting, he was kind of lonely on Saturday night, and I was too, so we went to dinner. And we told stories until about 1 in the morning. It seemed like it lasted 15 minutes. We became so connected. Lloyd and I had all of these moments. I don't know how this happens in life, and it's going to sound silly. But so I sent Lloyd, I was talking about wine, and I sent him this really nice aged French wine, and I sent him a note, and I said, sometime, light a candle, and have, and I said, I'm sorry for, the sitting, but a nice medium rare piece of tender wine, and a cheesy vegetable, and because he liked it. So that was fine. About 4 months later, I was on vacation with my family, and I didn't talk to Lloyd in a while, and we were walking around in Aspen in the little square there, and I just had this feeling like, God, I'm supposed to call him. I have no idea what I'm supposed to call him. I called him, and he just about fell on the floor on the phone, and he said, Dan, you're not going to believe this. I just lit the candles, and we just opened a bottle of wine. And Lloyd had, and Mike has some videos of him. We probably ought to send some of those out, because he's quite beacon of light for us, and I apologize for making this so personal for me, but God bless you all for being here, and I think we really have an opportunity to disrupt but change the world in an extraordinary way. So, thank you all.